in this edition of Art Loft. A composer reconciles seemingly incompatible musical genres.
What really is appealing to me is to try to make that music congeal into an organic whole.
Theater in a shipping container.
You can walk in one of the containers that has been converted into a bar, like Martini Drama.
Literary lovers explore the dark side.
This year's theme is the dark side, mystery, crime, and the literary thriller.
Meet a sculptor who knows what it takes to keep art alive, literally.
People ask me how I got into this, and I say that Willow chose me.
And a watery world of poetry.
Water, water, everywhere, and all the boards did shrink. Water, water, everywhere, and any drop to drink.
You should come here in winter.
It's all ahead on this edition of Art Loft.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation, Newman's Own, giving all profit to charity and pursuing the common good for over 30 years, and
in the Florida Keys and Key West, every night is a spectacular show, and every day is another masterpiece.
Hi, I'm Kaylin James, and from Coral Gables Museum in Miami, this is Art Loft. Welcome to tonight's show. Our first story features Los Angeles pianist Billy Childs, who merges classical music with smooth jazz. Raised in a household decidedly split between pop and Baroque music, Childs was practically fated at birth to bring these two genres together.
Dad was into the MJQ and the popular music of the day, Barbra Streisand, Nat King Cole. My mom was into like the Baroque music, like Bach, Haydn, Handel, Scarlatti. What really is appealing to me is to try to make that music congeal into an organic whole. Having been born and raised and living in Los Angeles, I kind of live under the tyranny of good weather. So when I went in 2007 to upstate New York during autumn, I was struck by how beautiful the autumn in New York was. The different colored leaves on the trees, the orange, the amber, the gold, the red, spellbound me. And I wrote this song, The Path Among the Trees, which was inspired by that scenario. I saw this little path as we were driving on I-95 that went into this forest of beautiful, this riotous profusion of colors. And I said, what would a journey be like down that path? To me, there's like a lot of different ways you can compose. You can compose as an impressionist, observing the outside world and writing your impressions of it, or you can be an expressionist, writing from the innermost, darkest places of your soul. You could write programmatic music, which tells a story, or just music, like as math, you know. Music for Two Quartets was commissioned for the Monterey Jazz Festival, and it's written for string quartet and jazz quartet, piano, bass, drums, and sax, and string quartet. This was a very large, ambitious piece. I wanted to write something that really was written for string quartet and jazz quartet.
Childs is the recipient of two Grammys and has performed with acclaimed musicians such as Yo-Yo Ma, Wynton Marsalis, and Chris Botti. For more information, visit BillyChilds.com.
This year's theme is the dark side, mystery, crime, and the literary thriller. Of course, the mystery and crime fiction genre are hugely popular in American letters.
Originating from Spain, microtheater brings the performing stage up close and personal. How close, you ask? Actors and audience members experience the world of theater in a shipping container. Really? From comedy to drama and musicals, microtheater even appeals to those with the shortest of attention spans. Take a look.
Microtheater is a concept that was created and started in Spain some years ago. And the concept, it's basically a 15 minutes play, short plays, theater plays, for 15 people. So it's always in small spaces, in unusual spaces.
We do all the theaters in a containers. So people walk into a containers, the first impression is always funny, because people ask, are you sure we're gonna walk into that container? And I tell them, listen, we're not gonna close it up and chip it back to Mexico. No, we're not gonna do that. You're gonna watch a show that is gonna be performed right close to you. The actors, which are big names actors, are right next to you. So it's a very intimate environment. And there is a lot of creativity at the moment when you stage up a play, because you can walk in one of the containers that has been converted into a bar, like Martini Drama.
When they walk in, they're pretty much gonna be set in a 1970s Blue Desire Bar. It's in a small town, and my character is called Maka. She used to sing at this bar, so she is well known in the town, but when she comes back, it's been quite a while, so the encounter is a bit different.
Oye, ¿qué pasó con el productor que es tan famoso? ¿Cómo era que se llamaba él? Francisco, ¿no?
¿Tú te acuerdas? Fernando.
Fernando, claro.
I thought it was just a great way to get people out of the mindset of, okay, this is theater because it's in a big venue and I'm far away from the stage and I'm separate from the story. Here, they're almost part of it, so I enjoy it a lot.
In my case, I'm the diva that's coming to end of her career and she doesn't want to realize that she's losing her goods, you know? And the other one is a shy victim kind of actress that's always doing the cover for me. When I'm not in the cast, then she gets the part. If not, I'm always getting in her way. So this is like a competition between us. It's very funny. It's very funny. It's the intimacy that you get from it. It's wonderful. People really enjoy it. It's a very unique experience. You feel like if you're in a very bohemia ambience. I mean, it's like a festival. It's very kind of hippie sometimes. We all get together. We get along between all the containers. We see our shows. We recommend it to the people. It's fun. And it's easy because it's only 50 minutes. So if you're not used to go to a theater, you just go, you see a play for 15 minutes. You're probably only $5. It's not even expensive. And you have your drinks and then you hear the people coming out and they gossiping. And I like this one, and I like the other one. So then you go with the flow, and you have a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun.
So the beauty about that is that you can experience different feelings going through these 7 containers. There are pure magic in every single one.
Microtheater now features plays in English. To learn more, log on to microtheatermiami.com or visit the Cultural Center of Spain in Miami at ccemiami.org.
There are many methods that I've used to do the living structures. Some involves the FEDGE method, the living fence, but this living tree one behind me is what I call a poling structure, has a metal substructure to it.
Since 1983, lovers of literature have traveled to the southern end of the Florida Keys in Key West to participate in the annual Key West Literary Seminar. This year's theme was The Dark Side. We met up with the event's associate director to learn more.
The Key West Literary Seminar is a nonprofit literary organization based in Key West. We were established in 1983, and we host an annual readers' conference. It's once a year in January at the San Carlos Institute in downtown Key West, and we look at a different literary topic each year. We bring in writers from all over the country and really from all over the English-speaking world. This year's theme is The Dark Side, mystery, crime, and the literary thriller. Of course, the mystery and crime fiction genre are hugely popular in American letters, and so we're having a double session seminar this year, both of which are completely sold out.
The idea of a book that changes you, the idea of a book that you do not understand on the surface, but that hits you on a deeper level is, that's what my favorite books are.
Right. We live in a society where we all have different religions, we all have different beliefs, and that's a really, really good thing, but we've created a secular mythology to make up for our lack of shared spiritual mythology. And I think the detective story is that secular mythology that ties us all together. It's so much fun. You know, for us writers, work is very, very solitary. So for us, it's a real treat to get up and get dressed up and put on a little makeup and meet all the other writers and talk to the fans and see that there's a world of real people who do read these books and who respond to our work. That's a real joy for us.
Never heard of any of them, so that was a great thing about this is finding out about new people that I had no idea existed. I've always read kind of classical fiction, but this is like a whole new world.
My full-time job is as director of the Key West Literary Seminar, but I'm a poet and a nonfiction writer, and I also run a small publishing press, and we publish literature and translation primarily by South American writers. I have a number of sort of overlapping literary activities that Key West is a great place for all of that. I think what really sets the Key West Literary Seminar apart from other events is this small scale, this community feel of the thing that we do, because everything takes place in one venue, the San Carlos Institute, which seats just under 400 people. You are, as an attendee of the event, you are together with the same group of people throughout the weekend, both in the audience and on the stage. And I think for the authors that we bring to Key West to, you know, present to our audience, I think for them it's a similar feeling. Not only do they get to interact all weekend long with their peers, these other great writers, but they get to know people in the audience who've come to see them. And writers certainly love spending time and talking with other writers, but more than anything, writers love talking to readers, the people who are buying their books, the people who are interested in the stories they're telling. And the Key West Literary Seminar really allows writers and readers to come together in a real face-to-face kind of one-on-one way that doesn't happen, you know, can't happen at bigger events that happen elsewhere.
Next year's theme is How the Light Gets In, Literature of the Spirit. To learn more about the seminar, visit kwls.org or fla-keys.com for everything arts and culture in the Florida Keys.
And all the boards did shrink. Water, water, everywhere. And any drop did drink.
You should come here in winter. Through rough water.
In this next story, we sat down with Bonnie Gale, an artist gaining recognition in New York and beyond for her signature living structures. Inspired by the willows of her native England, Gale combines nature with three-dimensional artistry.
I'm a willow artist. I contain and define space. And as an artist, I use willow, dead willow in the form of baskets, or whether it's live willow in the form of structures. And I started all of this in the 1980s. I started it with a small import business called English Basket Tree Willows. Since 2004, I've built over 40 living structures, and they are for all sorts of clients, from government agencies to corporations to schools to private clients. And I absolutely adore the work. It's highly creative. There are many methods that I've used to do the living structures. Some involves the FEDGE method, the living fence, but this living tree one behind me is what I call a poling structure, has a metal substructure to it. These living structures have a great potential to involve the community. For example, several years ago, I built this nearly 50-foot long tunnel in Baltimore on Pier 5, opposite the National Aquarium and Pierce's Park, and that involved the whole community. Every day, community people were coming and helping me. So these structures, whether they're geared for the public to be involved, just the public walking by, it's a wonderful form of community art. I love all the pieces I've made. The pieces I do nowadays tend to have greater complexity to them, and that's also based on my skills as an artist as I develop. I'm now getting larger requests for outdoor living rooms that definitely need a substructure within them, but the substructure does allow me to really do any shape I want. Thank you.
are tremendous challenges working with a live plant material. It would be much easier if I was working in metal or rock or some inert material. It's wonderful though, but yes, I'm working with a live material. I'm building space with a live material, and I've got to keep that live material around. I've got to keep it alive. I've been featured in House and Garden, Vogue Living, Vogue, Early American Life, Fiber Arts magazines. I've been on the Martha Stewart Show, that was April 2010, the PBS series Cultivating Life. It will actually self-root, it will self-graft. I mean, it's absolutely amazing plant material. People ask me how I got into this, and I say that Willow chose me.
For more information on Gail's work, visit EnglishBasketryWillows.com.
Number one. Step, 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 and you die, 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 die. Kill, 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 step,
step. You psycho!
Finally tonight, this short animation was commissioned in honor of UK's National Poetry Day. Created by Leo Crane with sound by Andrew Hayes, the film unites diverse voices of poetry in a dreamy, watery world to inspire children and adults alike. From MIA Animation, here's Water, Water.
Water, water, everywhere, and all the boards did shrink. Water, water, everywhere, and any drop to drink.
You should come here in winter, through rough water. Step out of a small boat, the taste of unclean salt
fall in love.
Fouling your lips.
I want to swim away to shore, stand up on my own 2 feet.
There, at the bottom of the river, time slips.
I keep a steady course. I only hear the water babble in my ears, the fizz of bubbles from the mountains.
Handfish are grand fish. They swim about in pairs, hold each other when they fall in love.
I bought a book of water, its covers bound in weed, its spine of mussled silver.
Look up, stars are gone. It's just us. Just us.
Crane won Best Student Animation at 2012's MIA Animation Festival. You can learn more about him at london-animation.com. And remember, this year's MIA Animation Conference takes place October 10th and 11th. Registration to compete is still open, so don't wait around. Log on to miaanimation.com. Well, that's our show tonight. Visit WPBT2.org/ArtLoft to watch past episodes and web-exclusive videos. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and now Instagram at ArtLoftSFL. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Kaylin James. Remember, stay creative. Bye.
Somebody lock it down, please. We're gonna be here all night long. All night.
Rolling.
Wait, what? Yay! Outro, outro, outro. Sorry, ma'am, no twerking on set.
Since looks like 1983,
yes, ma'am.
Richard had traveled to the southern end of the Florida Keys in Key West to participate in the annual Key West Literary Seminar. This year's theme was the dark side.
She went.
Hi, I'm Kaylin James, and this is a look.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation, Newman's Own, giving all profit to charity and pursuing the common good for over 30 years, and
in the Florida Keys in Key West, every night is a spectacular show, and every day is another masterpiece.